Rhode Show Kitchen is the place to be this morning. Chef Dan Murillo's here. Plantation at the Bay. We got roasted autumn squash and apple bisque. You have picked the perfect thing to put on the menu today at the beginning of fall. Good morning. Nice to have
you here. Good morning. Thank you very much. It's glad to be back.
Yeah.
We picked something very special for the autumn. It's getting cold outside. We want to warm up a little bit.
Yes.
So I figured we'd do something a little bit into season, you know, that we could, anybody can make with local ingredients. Go to Stop and Shop, get what you need. It's fantastic.
And simple and easy to use.
Simple and easy.
Just tell everyone what a bisque is. Basically,
a bisque is a soup. It's a little bit thicker, and it's a puree.
Okay.
So it's nice and smooth. It's not chunky, and it goes right down. It's perfect.
Perfect for today. All right, let's go over the ingredients because it's a little cool outside. You're going to want to make this tonight.
Absolutely. All right, so what we have here is some dried apples. They're Granny Smith's dried apples. We have some dark brown sugar. We have some butternut squash. We have some sugar pumpkin, whole unsalted butter, nutmeg, cinnamon, allspice, salt and pepper, fresh sage, celery, onions, and carrots, and a little bit of vegetable stock.
Okay, easy enough to do. Let's go over the apples themselves. Did you draw them out? I mean, I know you're a chef and everything else, but you can
buy them already dried out. Most of the varieties are Granny Smith apples that are already dried.
Right.
You can get them at Stop and Shop, Whole Foods. Just about any store will have them.
Okay, and put this together. All right,
exactly.
Easy enough to do. We're gonna put this together. We need the blender to blend this all together, or we're just gonna put it in here and it's kind of.
Well, you're gonna put it inside the pot. You're gonna cook it for some time. We're gonna roast off some vegetables.
Right.
And then after that, you put it inside of a blender or a hand mixer. You puree it up, strain it, and it's done.
Good. And you said the bisque is a little thicker than a regular soup that anybody else would have, and it is easy to make. We're gonna put this together. You'll be able to make this tonight on a cool fall evening. We're gonna put this together. Talk more about the restaurant itself and everything else that's going on. Back to you.
And you know what? We've been mentioning all those fall flavors that we're all looking forward to. Chef Dan has brought some of them into our kitchen this morning.
I did.
Bisque recipe.
Fantastic. Thank you very much. So we're going to do the first part right now.
Okay.
So that encompasses, let's see, we're going to take the butternut squash and the pumpkin, put it in a bowl here. And I have inside this pot here some melted brown sugar and butter. I'm going to put a little bit of sage in there as well. Just rip it up generously. We're going to pour that right in the bowl. We're just going to coat the squash and pumpkin.
If you don't have fresh sage, is it okay to use dried sage? You can use dried.
Absolutely.
Time of year, sometimes it's harder.
But, you know, when you roast in the oven, if you use dried, they may burn a little quicker.
Okay.
So I recommend using fresh.
All right.
Because you're roasting at high temperatures.
Good time.
So pour that right on here. Get it all even for us.
Even that brown sugar.
And then all we got to do is pop that right in the oven.
Time and temp there?
350 for about 30 minutes. They'll get nice and caramelized, nice golden color. And that's when you know it's done. Fork tender, that's it.
Beautiful. And I like the fact that something like butternut squash and pumpkin, they'll take about the same time to cook.
They both have the same density. So you're just right on point with being about the same.
Okay.
You just want to make sure you cut them like sizes.
This is something too that really anyone can tackle in the
kitchen.
I know sometimes you hear something like a word bisque and you think, okay, it's a little fancier. Is it going to be more difficult?
No. It's nothing to be afraid of. Bisque just implies it's pureed up and it's smooth.
Great.
So if you have a blender or a hand mixer, that'll puree it for you perfectly.
And a lot of the ingredients that you're using are so local and so
all
fresh.
All local, absolutely. This time of year, you can get pumpkins. Sugar pumpkins are gorgeous. Sugar pumpkins I choose because the texture is a little sweeter.
Okay.
It's meatier and less seeds. And if you have a little bit of seeds left over, you can do something fun with the kids. You could toast them in the oven. You can puree them up, make like a little pumpkin powder, add to hot cocoa or something. You know, it'll kick it up a little bit of notch.
Wow.
So that you can cross-utilize what you're using in the kitchen for the soup.
Options are endless. Okay, absolutely. Things are rolling here in the kitchen. We're going to finish things up when we come back.
Chef Dan Murillo joins us from Plantation at the Bay. We got roasted autumn squash and apple bisque. That's what we're making today. It's a great day for this.
It is. So we're going to start to finish this dish up here. I think our roasted squash and pumpkin is just about finished. It is.
Okay.
Gorgeous.
How long do you have to put that in for?
30 minutes.
Okay.
Or until fork tender. So
how
we have here inside
together.
This large... Here we have mirepoix, which is carrot, celery, and onions, and butter.
Okay.
So we're going to sweat this down until it becomes aromatic.
Okay.
Once it becomes aromatic, you can add our dried apples first.
Is it best to use dried apples? Can you use a fresh apple?
You can use fresh apples. I don't recommend it only for the fact that dried apples are dried. So what happens is in the cooking process, the liquids incorporate into the apples and the flavor from the apples get extracted into the dish.
Okay,
great.
So it just works out better that way for the dish.
Okay.
So we're gonna add here our roasted squash and pumpkin.
And that was just in a brown sugar.
It was a butter and brown sugar with the fresh sage. Roasted for 30 minutes at 350 degrees. All right, we're gonna add our vegetable stock.
It smells like fall in here.
That's great.
Nice.
Okay. Then we add a pinch of our seasons, a little bit of cinnamon, a little bit of nutmeg, a little bit of allspice. And we're gonna let this boil, bring it to a boil, and then we're gonna reduce it to a simmer.
Okay.
And then once you reduce it to a simmer, we're gonna cook it for about an additional 30 minutes, and then you can go ahead and you can put it inside the blender and puree it up once it's ready.
Great.
And then we have our finished product right here.
Oh my goodness, look at
that. This is what it looks like when it's finished.
No, Chef, could you also take an emulsion blender and put it directly into the pot?
If you have an immersion blender, you absolutely can stick it right inside the pot. Okay. Just be careful for the spray, because the soup will be hot. I recommend letting the soup cool for a few minutes before you start to puree it up, put it in the blender, because what will happen if you use the blender, the heat will start to build up, and it could actually explode at the top. So I recommend letting it cool just a little
bit. Good advice.
So you don't get burnt.
Good advice.
All right, so you have the finished product here.
Now, will this thicken up the longer it's...
It will. Well, I recommend keeping a little bit of chicken stock or water if you're on a budget. To loosen it back up so it's not super thick, but it definitely will thicken up as it cools. So once it's finished, we can just pour it inside the bowl here.
Wow. And you said you do a lot of soups at the restaurant, right?
We do. We do a couple of varieties. We do a seasonal based.
Mm-hmm.
In the summer, we do a New England clam chowder or something more summery, a gazpacho, chewed cucumber soup, something of that nature.
Yum.
In the winter, we try to keep it more hearty with a soup like this or a New England clam chowder, which is a thick white broth.
Mm-hmm.
That looks good.
But you do a lot more than that.
Oh, absolutely. So we have many things on the menu. We have a variety. We touch in, you know, all the seasons. We change our menu every season.
Good to know.
And we have a variety of seafood. We have meats. We have poultry, various items from poultry. We have lots of appetizers consisting of calamari, some seafood, stuff like that. So we try to hit all the bases with our menu so that people can come into the restaurant.
All right, we're into fall now, though. What do we expect?
We are into fall. Well, we are in the process of changing the menu. So we're going to do a couple different items. We're going to do a real nice bread pudding with some braised chicken and roasted mushrooms. It's going to be melted in the oven with some Gruyere cheese on top. It's going to be a fantastic dish. And we serve it over some nice creamy polenta. Nice and seasoned, a nice portion. We also are doing a deconstructed mushroom ravioli, which is going to be pasta sheets, how it's made, a little bit of roasted mushrooms as well, with truffle cream sauce, fresh truffles on top. So we try to keep it as hearty and with season as possible.
And where is the restaurant? Delicious.
The restaurant's in Jamestown, Rhode Island.
Okay.
We are open right now 6 days a week, only closed Tuesday. As of the 8th of next month, we will be open only 5 days.
Okay.
But we will start to do a la carte brunch on Sunday, starting at 11 o'clock. And that's something
brunch.
That many people have been asking about.
Sure.
So we want to let everybody know that we're going to be doing brunch. And we hope that we have a lot of people that come.
That's great.
I love brunch.
So here
we have
the finished product. And I actually made some of that little bit of pumpkin powder just because I had extra time. So this is the pumpkin seed. So if you have extra time to make the pumpkin seed powder.
Well, how do you turn it into powder?
How do you do that?
So what you do is you take the pumpkin seeds out of the sugar pumpkin. If you have any, you toast it in your oven for about 10, 15 minutes so they're crunchy. You put it inside of a little hand mixer, a blender, or a spice grinder. And you can just sprinkle it right on top of the soup. It gives it an extra pumpkin kick. Or you can, if you don't want to use it for that, you can put it, like I said, hot cocoa or something fun for the kids or the family. You know, it just adds an additional flavor or another complexity to any dish that you're doing.
I had no idea that you could make that.
I didn't know you could do that.
I just thought of roasting them and snacking on the seeds.
I need a spoon.
Something else. Okay, I gotcha. Do you want this one, Will?
I do. Give this, excuse me, thank you.
No problem.
Give this a taste.
You gotta give that a whirl. This is something that you're definitely gonna want to have on your menu all fall long.
Oh, we definitely have something just like this.
Yes. If you want to try this for yourself at home, you can find the recipe at WPRI.com.